Hi there! Are you a big dingus? Are you constantly perplexed by the fundamentals of cooking food? Then you need Cooking with Berserk. Using a knife to chop things? What are you, a coward? Just use this all-powerful artifact from the screaming depths of hell itself and try cooking with Berserk. Take these eggs, for instance. Scrambling eggs is one of the hardest things anyone has to do in the kitchen. But with the power of Berserk, you get delicious scrambled eggs in seconds. Just like Papa Betruger used to make.
Yes.
Berserk an apple. And never have to get one of those peeler, core, slicer thingies out of the drawer ever again. Berserk can be used to make delicious peanut butter. Or to mince an onion. Cooking with Berserk. Because we did not have a good idea for a cold open this week.
Oh dear! Oh, I had the volume turned up way too loud. Oof. Hello everybody and welcome back to another episode of I Coleman is Doomed. Yes, I'm apparently going to talk like this for this particular introduction. Just in time for cold and flu season, a nice deep voice. I am I Coleman, and I am playing through every single level of every single Doom game using only the pistol and the fist and the grabber and the artifact. But those last two only sometimes. We are currently playing through some level of Doom 3 Resurrection of Evil, and it's a good one. And we're doing it. Wow. This old thing's been a train wreck. As you can see, we are still very much cooking with Berserk. Just trying to give all these guys the punch, and that flaming barrel is no good, thank you. I do not remember what we're doing. We definitely have a task. I'm basically just sort of following the trail of monsters left for me. And yes, I'll take that, thank you. And we're facing a whole lot of skeletons just in time for... Well, I was gonna say just in time for Halloween. I guess just in time for the month Halloween is in. Listen, Halloween is year-round around these parts, both because we are always facing spooky monsters and because we are always experiencing terror and upset stomachs. Zombies continue to be the main threat to my survival here. I suppose I could waste a berserk on these fools. But why do that when you could just run out of run? Run out of run and get legitimately killed. Not a bit. So this is my third time attempting this. Oh no! Yes, I know. The AI getting stuck on things is no longer news. But you know what? It's funny every time. Uh-oh. Oh, he doing it! He doing it! Well, nevertheless. Stupid vulgars, I wanted to have fun! Oh! Was not expecting that, but fortunately, we will take care of that with a quickness. Where are we going now? Into nowhere? What? I can't go over what? What are we doing? A thorough waste of berserk. All right, we'll just kill this pinky with a FedEx box, a cardboard box, and a FedEx box again. Great. Boy, they did not think through. What? Bernard Fresco? Excuse me? Ice cold, refreshing fresco. It's a type of painting. I don't see anything bad. I don't, Job of the Hutt, is that you?
We now come back for Bordeaux.
Alright, what are we doing here? What about, it's just a Hell Knight. Well. Yay. And Revenant also. Oh man, more. It's the one advantage I've given the monsters in this game, is it takes 45 minutes to warp in when you're in slow-mo. Come on, I got the access card, let's go. Hey buddy, who wants a running back to pick up a corpse or the artifact montage? Oh, nobody? Nobody wanted that? Well, too bad.
meant to click on the health, but I clicked and activated the artifact.
Yeah, let's activate the sky tram. Yes! Yes, yes, yes! Yes, 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 yes! Sitting in a chair on the sky tram. Can't actually sit on it. Sky tram. Yay. Sky tram. Sky tram, sky tram, sky tram. Okay, well that just seems sort of needlessly cruel, Malcolm. Okay, that is kind of funny though. I gotta give him that. It's pretty good. Sky tram, sky tram, sky tram. I'm so happy this sequence is still going. Can you imagine if sky tram wasn't this exciting? You'd be all, geez, we had the same airlock animation twice. Just for a joke with a Hell Knight. Sky tram, sky tram, sky tram, sky tram. When I say sky, you say tram, sky, sky. I'm gonna assume you all left comments at exactly that point. Man, sky tram, I hate to see you go, but I love to watch you. Nope, couldn't commit to it. That joke, too stupid, say I. Let's go. That level was called Phobos Labs 1. This one's called Phobos Labs 2. Wow, we really paid that off from the beginning. All right, so what be the haps in this section? What's going on? What's that, vulgar? Are we just doing Delta Labs 1 again? Oh, this is something. What is this? How do I care about it? Do I need to put an epilepsy warning on this video? Probably should put an epilepsy warning on this video. Lot of artifact armor, a lot of splody barrels. Much to consider. Even more artifact. Lots of health. What are we doing? Oh, we gotta get PDA. Hey Liz, can you transfer me your PDA? In fact, hey, here's an idea. Liz, can you give me access? More health, more health, more ammo. That PDA, right? Pick up that PDA. That's when it all goes bad. Yes, gentlemen, as you can all see by this diagram, the shotgun. And what I believe may be a map for a classic Doom level of some kind. Looks like that. Seems like the kind of joke they'd put in. Yes, the PDA is James Owens. Let's go! Oh, well, that was my favorite monster right there. The absolute boy. You might have missed him because he went down immediately. Nah, you know what? I could reload and make a meal out of it, but no, I'm just gonna... That's the payoff all of last episode's build-up deserved.
God, it's good to see you. There's so much I need to explain.
Here's a fun thing to do. Watch Elizabeth's neck throughout this entire cutscene.
Explain, but we don't have much time, and there's always the danger of it being awakened, and then another invasion. The artifact is a gateway from hell. Core systems that must be shut down before I can reroute the power to the teleporter.
Troubling, isn't it? You know why they locked this door? Because jerks like me will 100% shoot Elizabeth McNeil for a dumb joke. Also, that area behind us is locked now, so can we talk about how they had all that health and all that ammo and all that buildup for two monsters, a Revenant and a Bruiser. And the Bruiser's cool, but you already gave me the thing that lets me kill him in one hit. So hang on, is this thing not coming with me? You're Elizabeth's sentry? Oh, okay, that's fine. No, it's fine. It's cool, it's fine. Well, anyway, I have to go the way where there's a walkway. Hello, it's me, smart man. Whatever that is. A access card. A still no air. You know what I think is cool? Breathing. No. You stop that. Oh, I guess there is air somehow. Either they don't know how airlocks work, or I don't. Come on. Dang it. Fine, I'll do it again. I'm not proud. What? I gotta worry about saving this? Come on, let's scoot. See, this is what I'm talking about right here. Hey! Stop it! Hey! Cut out! You're not supposed to be in here! No! Alright, there we go. Ugh. So, I've always liked the sound effect. You know what I don't love? Not having any idea where to go. Lift activated. All right. I would like to see it. Oh. Whoa, I'm actually out of artifact ammo. I just assumed I wasn't. Well, we are going to die pretty hard then. Well, let's try this again. This time with less actually bothering to stay behind and kill any of you. I'm more going to wherever the lift is. Not like I know where that is. Oh, that looks like a lift. You don't need to kill monsters. Oh, but my hair is green. And I can't tell if the audio was supposed to do that or if it's glitching, but here it is. It's the invulnerability hunter. Man, I wonder what I have to do for this fight. So I don't remember exactly how this fight works, and just for funsies, I won't look it up. He's throwing things, so presumably I need to throw those back at him. He doesn't seem the least bit perturbed by that. Yeah, hit him with the old Berserk. Yeah, it seems like it's doing some damage to me. Ugh. Okay, let's use this and blow. Wait, shouldn't those open? That one's got a green light on it. There we go. Come on. Did I blow it up? No. Ah, this sucks. There we go. Oh, we're doing something. I'm noticing a box of rockets, and there were more rockets earlier, so I think what they want us to do is damage him with rockets and not, for example, hurt ourselves by actually running into zappity zap range. However, we are of course dumb. We like to play games in a very silly way that makes no sense. And we will of course be continuing to berserk, no matter how badly it damages us. I think that's the last one. Yeah, that'll work. This fight's not over, huh? And I've used all my berserk ammo in this room, huh? And I've been saving after every single time I blew one of those things up, huh? Okay, well, we're gonna pistol the invulnerability hunter. This will work. Oh boy. Boy, oh boy, oh boy. I sure have made some bad decisions on this fine day. I'm guessing that, oh, nope, pistol's enough. Pistol's enough, you were killed by a gun for babies. Not literally for babies, of course, unless you live in America, in which case it's our constitutional right.
Good. Now take the Skytram to the reactor complex.
Take the what to the reactor complex? New objective, what? Oh, by the way, here's the Bruiser. He's a cool guy, he's got a TV face. It's a super weird design. I always enjoy the weird monster designs. He's very cool. He mostly dies in slow motion. Mechanically, he's kind of just another Hell Knight, but I just love the look and the design of him so much, and I would love for, like, Doom Eternal or something to bring the Bruisers back. But much more importantly than that... No? Yeah! Skytram.